What's up, friends? Thanks for being with us. It is Tuesday, July 30th. I'm Hayley Harmon alongside Seth Phillips.
Hey, what's going on?
What's going on this Tuesday? How are we?
A little stuffed.
Stuffed?
Had a big dinner last night.
Oh, and it's still with you this morning?
Still with me this morning.
That's how you know it was either really good or like really bad, and you have what I like to call sodi bloat, sodium bloat.
Is that what it is?
That's how I feel a little today.
I think
I had
just
a little too much salt last night.
Remember those plates that Macy's put out? Whenever it was like skinny jeans and mom jeans, and then like don't even try and wear jeans.
Mm-hmm.
That was my portion last night.
Oh, so. Don't even try and wear jeans. He's got on big sweatpants under here.
That's why we have a desk here.
So actually, I'm kidding. He has on leggings.
But. Yes. No. Porcupine meatballs is what I ate last night.
Porcupine meatballs?
Porcupine meatballs.
Out of actual porcupine or?
Yeah. Yeah, we went scoop it off the road, you know, after some roadkill and just make some meatballs out of it, spice it up a little bit. That's how we do it in Louisiana. What do you think? Want me to make you some?
Are you being serious or are you lying? I don't know. I don't even know who you are anymore, Seth. Or is that just the name of a...
What do you do? No.
What is that even?
It's okay. It's not porcupine, I'll tell you that.
I mean,
at ease.
I've never had it, so I can't
calm
judge.
Calm down,
yeah.
We're gonna be fine. No, but the reason why you call it porcupine meatballs is because you take, it's like rice and meat, a little bit of tomato sauce, you put it all together, mix it, spice it up, but the little meatballs, you roll with rice, uncooked rice at first, so
okay.
It sticks out kind of like little quills.
Oh.
And so it looks like a little baby porcupine.
I don't know that I want that. That doesn't sound good to me.
But it doesn't
include any porcupine. Good, but let's just not call it.
Why
I don't want to eat it. I don't want to eat.
That's adorable to have a little bitty, you know, like a bunch of little porcupines.
Something about that freaks me out. Something about that freaks me out.
I love telling the story though whenever I eat it because people are like,
yeah.
Did you really go get some
porcupine
off the side of the
road? Some people are really into
No, in Louisiana, they eat some
wild
weird
game.
Critters, yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway,
interesting.
That's,
one of the things that I've, speaking of foods I've never had, have you ever had Guetta?
Like David Guetta?
Yeah, like David Guetta. Have you ever had David Guetta?
Nope, can't say that.
No, it's something that I'd never had, and a lot of you guys, I'm sure you eat it. I'd never had it until I moved to Kentucky. I'd never even heard of it.
Right.
It's like a breakfast meat.
Mm.
So the one place where I've gotten it is Josie's restaurant here in Lexington. They do a great brunch and lunch.
Okay.
And some of my friends here in Kentucky, hi Colleen, she introduced me to it. And it's like, she said it's more of like a Kentucky, sometimes Northern Kentucky, kind of Cincinnati thing. It's like sausage, but with like oats in there. It looks like sausage patties. But it kind of has like oats mixed in, kind of like how yours had the rice in there.
Yeah.
I think that's right. If I'm wrong, correct me, please. But it's something to that effect.
Oh.
It's not just meat.
No, I can't say that I have.
It's got really good flavor to it.
Interesting, though, that in the Cincinnati area is also that does the chili, like the Skyline
like
chili
Skyline
with
or,
a little bit of cinnamon.
Uh-huh.
Is that what they put in?
Yeah.
I haven't tried it yet.
I've tried it. It's good. You know, now that we have the Skyline here, it is a little different. It has a little different flavor to it than the chili. Are you a beans in your chili guy
Can't
or just meat?
Nope.
No beans?
Mm-mm.
I love
beans. Ma'am. Just I want the meat and the cheese, some jalapeno Fritos mixed in.
Oh, Fritos. Mm. When I was in high school, our concession stand at our football game sold, you know, you could buy, did the thing
the
where
Frito
they,
pie.
The Frito pie, yeah,
right.
Where you just open the bag and they pour the chili down in there and then you eat it with a... God bless. It is so good. Thank you, Lord, for these gifts from above.
Blessings. All right. Well, on the show today, we are talking about the Kentucky Bank Tennis Championships.
Yeah.
They are underway right now at UK, and they draw tennis pros from all around the world.
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, it is the pathway to the U.S. Open. So if you watch these players here at UK, literally in just a few weeks' time, you could be watching them
That's
in the U.S. Open. And it is Tuesday, so we've got this week's LEX 18 half-off dining deal. It comes to us from a well-known chef located in Georgetown. You got to stay with us to find out what restaurant it is.
Fun stuff.
Okay, this could be a huge turn of events. The infamous no call, who could forget this, from January's NFC Championship game is back in the headlines. Here's what's going on. A Louisiana judge has ordered NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell and three officials from January's NFC title game between the LA Rams and New Orleans Saints to answer questions under oath about the no call, a play where LA's nickel Roby Coleman appeared to interfere with Tommy Lee Lewis of the Saints. Here it is. People were freaking out over this because... it affected the outcome of the game.
Yeah.
Attorney Antonio Lemon, who filed a lawsuit over the game, says he and league attorneys will pick a date for depositions in New Orleans, barring any league appeals that might delay or cancel the questioning. The lawsuit seeks $75,000 in damages to be donated to charity over the failure to flag the play. The no call came at a crucial point in the game as the Saints were driving late in the fourth quarter to potentially win, but they didn't. The Rams eventually won and advanced to the Super Bowl. So, what do you think?
It needs to happen.
I think so, too.
There's not one person in the country, unless you're an LA Rams fan, that is like, oh, that was a no call, and it should have been that way. No, look at that. It's targeting. It's clear as day. Targeting with the helmet.
Oh, geez. Yeah, not only interference.
I'm not saying that the Saints would have necessarily gotten to the Super Bowl, but they had a very good chance towards the end of that game and missed a call.
You know, and I feel like this is what we want a lot of times. We just want someone to answer questions over stuff. A lot of times when you're watching a game, you're like, I just want to know why the refs did that and want them to be held accountable, especially when it affects the outcome or it appears to have affected the outcome.
Yeah, and it wasn't, I think after the game, they talked to the referee who was in, I think it was the player, and he was like, I targeted.
Yes.
That's what happened. I targeted. But the referee never called it, so they just went with it.
This is interesting. We'll
see
what happens.
A lot of people in Louisiana are really excited about this this potential. So
yeah, and your old stomping grounds, that's for sure. Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what could come from this.
Right.
You know.
And how we go forward in NFL games or even college football games for that matter with the referees and what they call and what they can't and just the oversight over something like that. So, all right, a California jury decided that Katy Perry's 2013 song Dark Horse copied part of another song called Joyful Noise from a Christian rap artist called Flame. The unanimous decision from the 9-person jury came following a week-long trial. Flame, whose real name is Marcus Gray, says Dark Horse took an underlying beat from his song without permission. Lawyers for Perry argued that the portion of the song he's referring to is coming to have a copyright protection. The New York Times reports the penalty phase of the trial is scheduled to start on Tuesday. It will determine how much Perry and her co-writers will have to pay in damages.
I mean, I don't know that much about songwriting. I will just say that off the top, but I was doing some reading about this morning, and her attorney's main argument was the part that they were saying was copied is so
generic.
They were like, if you say that this is copying, then this is going to have big ramifications for all songwriters music in general. If we're not allowed to have something, because they called it a derivative, they're like, it kind of sounded like it is a derivative, but it was so basic. It's like the basic one of the, I think they said, the building blocks of music. Sure. If you say this is copying, then everything's
copying.
We
only have so many notes in music. Right. It's 2019, and by this time we've had so much pop music that everything is just starting to sound repetitive. So it's only a matter of time before a beat or a line of melody or something gets copied, and then obviously we're going to have some lawsuits over it. But yeah, I mean, it's expected at this point.
I think so. But yeah, I would like to get on and listen to it, because I mean,
and see how similar they sound.
Just how similar, if it is like obviously a carbon copy. But even then, it's like if it's just.
And we've seen this in the past. There's been MC Hammer's Can't Touch This, and then was that one song that's like, she's a very funky girl.
What? Keep going. I can't place it.
Something, something, mama.
No, I'll need more.
That's all I know.
Dang it!
That's all I got for you.
I know what song it is. Okay. I just want you to keep going. You killed it. I loved it.
Nailed it.
A sneaky lion tried to spook a young visitor at a zoo in Louisiana over the weekend. One of the new lions at the Audubon Zoo in New Orleans. This is so funny. Look, tried to sneak up on a little boy over the weekend. I bet he was thinking this little boy is lunch. The surreal moment was captured on video. A child was sitting in front of the exhibit facing away from the glass and did not see the lion approaching him, thank goodness. Once he turned around, the lion pounced and began pawing at the window. A baby was then placed next to the window and the lion continues to paw away. Yeah, I don't think this was the lion being like, let's play peekaboo.
No,
he was thinking lunchtime.
No, this is what I'm designed. Oh, let's have another snack.
That scares me. I don't care how thick that glass is. That makes me so nervous.
I love it. I mean, not obviously in the real world, but I think this is hilarious when people do this. They turn their back to a lion or a tiger or whatever, and then they just come at you.
The tiger's like, oh, I oughta.
I like that swipe too.
Yeah.
Like,
hey.
Boom.
It's like, love it.
All right, a Phoenix, Arizona man has a message for pet owners who fail to clean up after their pet. A man says a dog owner has been letting their dog poop in and around his yard for several weeks now. A man circled a spot of poop on the sidewalk with chalk and left a message for the dog owner, hoping it would draw attention to the issue. Says his attempt at communicating with the unknown owner did not work. Since bringing attention to the incident with chalk, the man claims the frequency of the droppings has increased. Well, no duh. You bring attention to something like that, and people are just out of spite going to be like, all right, that's the yard we're going to let our dogs poop in.
Or maybe it's a stray, and the stray can't read. Has anybody stopped to think about that?
or the stray can read and is like,
this video, guys, ooh, that's a lot of
gratuitous poop shots.
Gratuitous poop shots is what that
was. We need more of that in our life.
Goodness gracious. Always pick up after your pet. Always do it. It's just gross because when you don't, I always think like, A, in the summertime, flies get on there and you know what they produce and it's nasty. Well,
it's bad for the environment. You
it
don't
is.
Want that flushing down into the,
down
like
into
the sewage
yes.
and all that.
But it just, also, yeah. Someone else could step in it, or you could step in it, because you'll forget that you didn't pick it up, and then...
Gross.
An Alaskan police officer is about to have a close call with a pair of jaywalking moose. Check this out. The mama moose... Oh, my gosh. Thank goodness for his brake pads. The mama moose trotted out of the way after a trip, but the calf ran back to the other side. Traffic in the oncoming lanes was also forced to stop after the calf finally caught up with its mama. Both are reported to be okay. They made it safely across the road. Officials say Alaska, has one of the highest rates of vehicle moose collisions in the world.
Like?
Road rash.
Yeesh. Yeah, right?
Poor little thing. I'm so glad they didn't hit.
Yeah.
Have you ever hit an animal while you've been driving?
No. I've been lucky so far, and I've driven the Bluegrass Parkway at night.
Yeah, you're like really taking your life into your own hands. 2 o'clock
in the morning when there's no lights, and you know at some point there's going to be, and I've seen them. In my periphery, I'm seeing deer on the side of the road. I'm like, no. And then finally I get past it, and it's fine.
I know, I get so nervous.
Oh, but I'm like, one is going to jump out, and I'm going to have to.
And when you're on the interstate, I mean, it is so dangerous because you're going so fast. I mean, that would just, yeah.
And I don't even want to know what, you know, the front of my vehicle is going to look like after that point. It just a terrible thing all around. All right, a California architect's art installation is turning to the U.S.-Mexico border wall into a playground. This portion of the wall in New Mexico is being called the Teeter Totter Wall. You can see the wall was turned into a fulcrum for a handful of seesaws.
Oh, a fulcrum, you
say? Right, yeah, I used a big word there. The artist hopes it helps remind people that children and adults on both sides of the border are connected in meaningful ways.
This is cool. I haven't been on a seesaw in years. When I was a kid, the seesaw was my jam.
I was on one 2 days ago.
Were you?
Yep, fun fact.
Please tell me you were... Where?
No, I was just by myself.
You were? You were by yourself?
I
running from side to side.
I didn't have anybody to play with, so I was on the seesaw all by myself. But no, that's a really good story, though, to see that. Especially with all of the political right now with the border wall. It's like just to have some connection.
Yeah, something a little light and breezy.
Yeah, a little levity in the situation. Yeah. We'll take it.
Okay, check out what TSA discovered inside one man's luggage in Baltimore on Monday. A missile launcher. Ooh. TSA says officers detected it while screening checked luggage. They called airport police, who then tracked down the passenger. TSA reports the Texas man told officials he was a service member traveling home from Kuwait. Apparently, he wanted to keep the missile launcher as a souvenir. Officials confiscated it, though, and gave it to the state fire marshal for disposal.
Really?
Turns out you can't take your missile launcher with you on a plane.
Yeah.
What is the world coming to?
That's the one thing right there. Oh, my goodness. All right. A road cable stayed bridge with the world's largest and heaviest span Tuesday completed its closure after being rotated into position in northern China. The bridge is to have 8 lanes on its 130-foot wide deck, with the main bridge being about a third of a mile long, and it spanned 800 feet long as well. The bridge's total weight is being rotated is 81,000 tons.
Jeez Louise.
Isn't that cool,
though? It's amazing how they, the engineering that goes into something like this.
Yeah, that's
is
what
so
I was
going
to say. It's just this day and age to have something that massive be able to
rotate.
I love it.
Just look at it. Okay, stay with us straight ahead. This week is your chance to watch pro-level tennis players from around the world.
That's right. They're at UK this week for Kentucky Bank Tennis Championships. More details when we come right back.